Bismillahirrahmanirrahim and assalamu alaikum students. I hope you all would be fine. Today I am going to teach you New Oxford Primary Science of Level 4. Kindly open the books please. Students, in the previous chapters we have discussed about the first chapter and then we did our exercise on our workbook. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Unit 2, Food and a Balanced Diet. But actually balanced diet is that eating proper amount of healthy food in proper on proper time in a proper manner. Okay, how it I'm going to tell you of that. Okay, in this chapter we will be able to learn about the living things that need food to live, all need a balanced diet to keep healthy. Food contains proteins, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals which are needed by our body. Then we will work on our food pyramid, what is food pyramid, and after that how we can preserve food. Okay, before that we have to start the chapter. Okay, food is important. Food gives us the energy to work and play. Means what is the function importance of food? Food gives us energy. Energy, what is energy? Ability to do work. Okay, so food gives us energy to do work and play. Okay, when you do anything you use up energy. Means when we want to do something we use up energy. While you are sleeping it seems as if you are doing nothing. Means but sometimes you see that when you are sleeping you think that you are doing nothing. Okay, however your stomach is digesting food. Still your stomach is digesting your food. Your brain is working, your lungs are breathing, your heart is beating. All of them is just because of the energy, and that energy where it comes from, it's your food. Okay, all of them need energy to work properly. Okay students, sorry, all food have different food values. See, all food have different food values. Some foods helps you to grow, some foods gives you energy, other foods build up the fats in your body. Means everything adds its own function. Some foods help you to grow, some helps you to grow, give you energy. Other foods build up fats in your body. Some foods help to build up particular cells in your body. Some foods help to fight. Sorry, here it's missing. But let me tell you, some foods helps your body to fight against germs. Okay, so I'm going to complete it. Some foods helps your body to fight against germs. Germs that's attacking your body and making you a ill person. Okay, and prevent infection. See, healthy foods, no infections. If you eat only one kind of food, it cannot do all these jobs. Means if you are eating only one kind of food, these all jobs cannot be performed. Okay, so you need to eat a variety of foods to get all the nutrients you need. So you people have to eat a variety of foods to so that you maintain this, that you have all the nutrients you are taking. Okay, when you eat all the proper foods, we say you have a balanced diet. Means when you are eating all the proper food, means you are eating a healthy diet, balanced diet. A balanced diet keeps you healthy. Means it is keeping you healthy. Okay students, balanced diet, what is a balanced diet? Okay, before that let me tell you about, do you know breakfast is the most important meal of the day? It's very important, you must eat it. Eating a healthy breakfast is the best way to start your day. Means breakfast is the most important meal, so eating a healthy breakfast is the best way to start your day. Okay students, after that we have balanced diet. A balanced diet means eating the right variety of foods in the right amounts. Eating a balanced diet helps us to be fit and healthy. Okay, means eating proper amount, right amount of food, variety of foods in the right amounts, eating a balanced diet helps us to be fit and healthy. Okay, see, grains, bread, rice, potato, corn, spaghetti, porridge, cereal, these are a balanced diet. Okay students, after that students come to the next page, discuss and answer. Look at these two plates. What makes the meal on the left a balanced meal? What makes the meal on the right an unbalanced meal? See over here, they are giving you a cup of milk. See, vegetables, minerals, everything is there, fruits. But here you see cakes, ice cream, and you know, Lays. After that your burgers, cokes. That's very unbalanced meal. This is balanced because it contains all the appropriate, they contains carbohydrates, fats. I'm going to, in the next time in the with the passage, I'm going to tell you what actually they are. Okay, so this is balanced meal and this is unbalanced meal. Why? Because it contains all the amounts and it do not contains all the amounts. It's just, you can say, junk food, unhealthy food. Okay, After that, to eat a balanced diet, avoid junk food. Means we have to avoid junk food. Junk food is the food that has low nutritional value. Low nutrition means it has no as such nutrients. It is high in fat or sugar. Means it is high, its fat level is high and sugar is very low in and it's where in fiber, proteins, vitamins or minerals. Means it's have no its nutrition is less very. So that's why they are unbalanced. Junk food is usually high processed. Highly processed means they are going through a channel, proper channel. Firstly, they will, you know, like it's Coke. Coke is processed by several ways. Means they just it's the condensation of carbon monoxide, but it's very gases are processed and gives you a Coke. So that's are not good for your health. Fizzy drinks and fast foods are junk foods. What are your junk foods? Fizzy drinks, chilled drinks. Like Coke, Pepsi, Dew, everything in fast food. We mean burger, Lays, ice creams, donuts. These all are just fast foods. Okay, these are junk foods. Okay, now students, we are going to start our basic chapter needs or basic the requirements of the chapter, that are food groups. We are here discussing food groups. Okay, food can be divided into groups according to what they do for the body. Means what they want to do for our body. Okay, students. So food can be divided into a groups according to which they do for the body. Means groups are which one? Carbohydrates, dietary fibers, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Which one? Carbohydrates, dietary fibers, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, different foods can contain a number of these things that body needs. Means they contain a number of things that the body are require. Okay, students. For example, many vegetables contain vitamins, minerals and dietary fiber, and cheese is a very good source of protein. Very people are familiar. Means many vegetables have vitamins, minerals and dietary fibers, and cheese is a very good source of protein. Okay, students, calcium and fats are also. Here is more information about what carbohydrates, dietary fibers, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals do for the body. And with examples they are given, but these all are biomolecules or life molecules. They are necessary for the life. Which one? Carbohydrates, dietary fibers, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. These are all needed by our body in a specific amount. These are known as food groups in our life. Okay, after that, students, we have carbohydrates. First is one is, let me introduce you carbohydrates, main energy giving foods. These are the main energy giving foods. Okay, if you are working or running about a lot, you need carbohydrates to give you energy. Means you are doing extra exercises, you need to work on your intake of carbohydrates. Okay, so that it can give you a lot of energy. Okay, too little will make you tired. Means if you have less energy, you will be getting tired soon. Too much may make you fat. Means too much will make you fat and less will make you weak. Carbohydrates are the major source of quick energy for us. Means carbohydrates the quick energy source of quick energy source for the body. Foods in this contain fiber which helps with digestion. Means in with this carbohydrates we have also some fibers. Fibers is also chemical compounds which are helping in our digestion. Okay, see examples: grains, bread, rice, potato, popcorn, spaghetti, porridge and cereals. Okay, and one thing, that carbohydrates are sweet in nature. Okay, so anything that having a good sweet taste, that can be categorized in the carbohydrate, students. Okay, students, now move to the next page. Now students, see over here, next after carbohydrate we have dietary fibers. Okay students, what actually are dietary fibers? It is the part of food you cannot digest. Means it is indigestible part of your food. It has no food value, but it helps to move the waste through the digestive system. But it is helping you to release your waste from the digestive system. It is found in a wide range of foods. Okay students, means dietary fibers has no nutritional value, but it has one very great effect, that is that it helps you to waste your excretion material or excretory material of outside your body. Okay, so that the main role of dietary fibers, it stops the one of the major disease of your body, that is constipation, and constipation is mother of all diseases. So dietary fibers are very important. It includes fruits, vegetables, brown bread, whole grains, etc. Okay students, very important. After that, students, we have proteins. Very important. They also gives us energy and bodybuilding foods. Bodybuilding means they are making your all the body, okay? And that makes us grow. Means we are growing. See, our skin is growing with the time. It's just because of the proteins, okay? They helps our body to build up and repair tissues and muscles. Means they help our body to build up and repair tissues and muscles, okay? They enable your body to replace dead cells. Means if due to inside, especially in winter, our skin is just peel off and that is replaced by new cells, and the dead cells are just removed, okay? That's just because of the proteins. And what proteins include? Fish, meat, beef, mutton, chicken, beans, eggs, dairy products like milk, yogurt, cheese, etc. Okay, students, after that, students, we have fats. Fats gives us energy and helps to keep the body warm. Okay, students, means fats gives us energy and helps to keep the body warm. So is it important to have some amount of this group in our diet? Too much of these foods can make us fat. Means if we are taking fats in high amount, we will be getting obese, okay? Obese or fatty, okay? So you have to take in proper amount. Too much of the can make us fat. As I've told you, healthy fats are less processed fats. Less processed means they are not in a processed manner, like butter. Butter is made in a factory or industry by means of a very processing techniques, so that always that food healthy fats are less processed. Means they are not from a highly specific machines, or they are not they are not actually originated from the many processing types. Okay, after that example, margarine, butter, cheese, nuts, meal, fatty meats, ice cream, fried foods, sweets, chocolates, cake, etc. So they are not too much good for your health. Okay, students. So after that, we have a concept check. See, concept check, students, I have completed. I want you to complete it too. Complete the following sentences. We need to eat the right amount of what? Proteins, fats, dietary fibers, and carbohydrates. Okay, you have to write proteins because we have to take it in the right amount. Proteins, fats, dietary fibers, and carbohydrates. After that, now use the keywords. Keywords, we have to make a keywords. How? Which tree gives us energy? Which tree gives us energy, students? See, we have talked about proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. These three are energy. And while dietary fiber has no nutritional value, no food value, it's just helping us in digestion. Okay, students? After that, which one helps us to build and grow? Which one helps us to build and grow? Proteins, because they are our building blocks. Which one has no food value but still helps to move waste along? See, I told you already that the dietary fibers are the only one which are just there for you in digestion but has no nutritional value. So you have to write dietary fibers. After that, which two can make us fat if we eat too much of them? Means what are the two things which we are going to eat a lot and we will be having the obese body? Okay, so fats and carbohydrates. So two of them are fats and carbohydrates. So you have to write fats and carbohydrates over here. Okay, students, till then you have to check all of these things and you must have a proper diet, balanced diet. And in the next lecture, we will inshallah discussing about the remaining part of blood food groups, and you will be able to learn about the different food groups. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.